dike to prevent runoff and provides an undirected flow of water onto the field, it is herein called a basin. If the basins are small or if the discharge rate available is relatively large, there are few soils not amenable to basin irrigation. Generally, basin irrigation is favored by moderate to slow intake soils and deep-rooted, closely spaced crops. Crops which do not tolerate flooding and soils subject to crusting can be basin irrigated by furrowing or using raised bed planting. Basin irrigation is an effective method of leaching salts from soil profile into the deeper ground water. Basin irrigation systems can be automated with relatively simple and inexpensive flow controls at the basin inlet. However, basin irrigation has a number of limitations in association with agriculture in the less developed countries. Accurate land leveling is prerequisite to high uniformities and efficiencies, but this is difficult to accomplish in small areas. The perimeter dikes must be well maintained to eliminate breaching and waste, and it is difficult and often infeasible to incorporate the use of modern farm machinery in small basins, thereby limiting small-scale basin irrigation to hand and animal-powered cultivation. Coming to the last method of implementing surface irrigation method, that is border irrigation system. In many circumstances, border irrigation can be viewed as an expansion of basin irrigation to include long rectangular or contoured field shapes, longitudinal but no lateral slope, and free draining or blocked conditions at the lower end. In border irrigation, a field is divided into strips separated by border ridges running down the slope of the field. The width of the strips is usually 20 to 100 feet. The area between the ridges is flooded during irrigation. Border irrigation is used for tree crops and crops as alfalfa and small grains. Let's have a look at the slide. Border irrigation is suited for vegetables that can withstand flooding for a short time. It can be used for all crops provided that the system is designated to provide the needed water control for irrigation of vegetable crops. It is suited to soils between extremely high and very low infiltration routes. In border irrigation, water is applied slowly. The root zone is applied water gradually down the field. At a time, the application flow is cut off to reduce water losses. Ideally, there is no runoff and deep percolation. The problem is that time to cut off the inflow is difficult to determine. This was all about the basic design principles of irrigation system. One of the disadvantages of surface irrigation that confronts every designer and irrigator is the soil which must be used to convey the water over the field has properties that are highly varied both spatially and temporally. They become almost indefinable except immediately preceding the watering or during it. This creates an engineering problem in which at least two of the primary design variables, discharge and time of application, must be estimated not only at the field layout stage but also judged by the irrigator prior to the initiation of every surface irrigation event. Coming to the next slide, let's study sprinkler irrigation system. The sprinkler system is ideal in areas where water is scarce. A sprinkler system conveys water through pipes and applies it with a minimum amount of losses. Water is applied in form of sprays, sometimes simulating natural rainfall. The difference is that this rainfall can be controlled in duration and intensity. If well planned, designed and operated, it can be used in sloping land to reduce erosion where other systems are not possible. The last is fully permanent system. In this, laterals, mains, sub-mains as well as pumping plant are permanently fixed. Sometimes laterals and main lines may be buried. The sprinkler may be permanently located or moved along the lateral. It can be used on permanent irrigation fields and for relatively high value crops. Labor savings throughout the life of the system may later offset high installation cost. Now let's have a look at subsurface irrigation. Subsurface irrigation is applied in places where natural soil and topographic condition favor water application to the soil under the surface. These conditions include impervious soil layer at 15 cm depth or more, pervious soil underlying the restricting layer, uniform topographic condition, and moderate slopes. The operation of the system involves a huge reservoir of water and level is controlled by inflow and outflow. The inflow is water application and rainfall, while the outflow is vapor transpiration and deep percolation. It does not disturb normal farm operations. Excess water can be removed by pumping. The suitability of various irrigation methods, that is surface, sprinkler or deep irrigation, depends mainly on the natural conditions, type of crop, type of technology, previous experience with irrigation, required labor inputs, and costs and benefits. So this was all about development of irrigation schedule. In the next session, we will be discussing about application of manures and fertilizers. Thank you.